Hello, this is Big Lou from Florida Roadways, and I just left the gas station. I'm just driving along Southwest 88th Street. This is going to be a nighttime video. The time is 3:56 a.m. So this is going to be a 40-minute video. What I'm not gonna do is drive through the neighborhoods at this time, because you know, the cops might pull me over and they're gonna think I'm doing something suspicious, and I'd rather just drive on the main roads like this one to make it look like I'm going somewhere else, and just to make it look less suspicious. I know people stream on YouTube at all times of the night, but at 4 a.m. it's, you know, it's really not worth it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drive west, and then I'm gonna go south. Yeah, I'm gonna go west towards Chrome, and then I'm gonna Chrome Avenue, and then I'm gonna go south towards probably Florida City. this street used to be two lanes going west and two going east. It was just four lanes back then, and then they extended it to, you know, three lanes going west and three going east, so that's six lanes right there. And I remember taking this road with my father. He was doing about maybe 70 miles an hour. This used to be a 55 mile zone, maybe 60. And I think I went with him to the shooting range because it used to be all the way further west, but a little bit north, probably about 15 minutes from here. And this was when he had a 72, 73 Cadillac Eldorado. And those were beautiful cars back then. Before that, he had a Buick Skylark, and that was a nice car too. I think it was a GS. It was a fully loaded car, and so was the Eldorado. But it was good that they extended the lanes because, oh God, there was a lot of traffic. And there was nothing around here. There were no houses, no shops back in the 70s and 80s. And they built all this in the mid-90s. The shops and the houses, you know, like the Publix. And, but these condos on the left, they built that almost 10 years ago. For one bedroom, starts at about $2,400 a month. And no, I'm not exaggerating, but if you go on Zillow and if you type in, what was it, Kendall Lakes, Florida, I don't know the zip code. I think it's, what was it, 33186 or 33196. And this area is Kendall Lakes, Florida, or you can type in hammocks. I think it's Kendall Lakes. Yeah, it's dark out here, man. Activity. Wonder what happened. Okay, I see a pickup and I see three cop cars. And I see another car, so there's two cars, two vehicles and three cop cars. Looks like somebody got hit from behind because I see a busted taillight. I better watch my speed because the speed limit's 50 and I'm doing a little bit over 50. So one of those cop cars are going to be headed this way, probably in about 5 to 15 minutes, I'd say, because who knows how long they've been there. this street that I'm on, they also extended the number of lanes. It used to be one lane going south, one lane going north. This used to be a pretty dangerous road back in the 90s. Well, I started driving on the late 80s, I remember being on this road, or early 90s. There have been several head-on collisions from what I remember, but there have been anywhere from maybe 15 to almost 30 fatalities each year on this road. And this is about maybe a 35 mile road, almost 40, I'd say, which takes you from North Miami to Florida City, which is in Southwest Miami. But now they added two lanes going south and two going north, which is four lanes. Plus, they added street lights, and they added these guardrails on the median, which is a good thing in case you have a tendency of falling asleep on the road, and if your car veers to the left, you'll be hitting the guardrail. Veers to the right, well, most likely you'll hit a street light or the speed limit signs, you know. Hopefully you don't get killed. That these street lights are blue. Looks pretty cool. Most likely they might replace them because I don't know, the county or the city, they won't accept it. It's a malfunction, like I said on my previous videos. It's the first time I've seen this at night. The street lights that you see on the left. Well, yeah, they replaced these LED lights. I think it was a few years ago, maybe almost 5 years ago, I don't remember. I think those are energy saving LED lights. that gas station is open 24 hours. And then there's two of them after that traffic light, I think. There's one on the left that I see, and then there's one on the right. The one on the left is a racetrack. That one's open 24 hours, I think. Southwest 177th Avenue. Yeah, there's a racetrack that's open, an Exxon that's open. I'm on Chrome Avenue and Southwest 200th Street. And I'm headed south towards Homestead. I'm in the Redlands right now. Speeding, and the speed limit's 45. It used to be 50, but as soon as I approach Homestead, it's gonna be 30. So that's where I really have to watch my speed there, because the Homestead police are very strict on speeders, especially around this time. So time is 4:17 a.m. gas station on the left, but that one's closed, and the one on the right is closed, so those two aren't open 24 hours, I don't think. Now the pumps might be open for self-serve fuel. Okay, I'm approaching Southwest 288th Street. As soon as I pass 288th Street, which is that green traffic light ahead, I will be in Homestead. Okay, right now I'm in Homestead. Speed limit is 45. Avocado Drive. I think there's a field around here that sells avocados. Sure. Okay. Speed limit's 30. Okay, I'm good. Okay, right now I'm in the city of Homestead. I remember when I was driving on this street late at night, there was some guy that was driving on the wrong side of the road. He was driving on the left side, and he was probably drunk, and then he turned right here on this road. I was thinking about passing him, but I didn't want to try. So I stayed way behind him. Or her, but you know, it could have been a guy. And I looked to where he turned, and that was it. What really bothers me is when, you know, some people, you know, they panhandle or hang out in front of the gas station late at night. Well, it bothers me when they hang out at the gas station, period, you know, especially when they're drinking alcohol. Asking for change, and you know, in a way, I feel sorry for them. You know, some of them are homeless. If you're jobless, you know, what am I saying? You don't get any income. But then, of course, you know, somebody will give you money, especially through, you know, Cash App. Channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell, and share the broadcast, please. I appreciate it. gonna stop the video right here. You'll have a good day, a good night from wherever you are around the world. This is Big Lou signing off, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.